Okay, once again, they asked of him, remember it said in Exodus 3 and 14, and the Most High said by the angel of the Most High that we read in Exodus 3 and 2, unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, thus shall I say unto the children of Israel, I am have sent me unto you. That's the first thing he said to him. But remember, he asked him first and foremost in verse 13, the power of your fathers. See? He said, Moses said unto the Most High through the angel, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel and shall say unto them, the power of your fathers have sent me unto you. Right? And we establish the power of our fathers as the power of Abraham, power of Isaac, power of Jacob. So now when we go to John, the eighth chapter. Let's go deal with Exodus 3:14. And the Most High said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, thus shall I say unto the children of Israel, I am have sent me unto you. That's the first thing he said, I am have sent me unto you. So now when we go to John 8:53, it says, art thou greater than our father Abraham, which is dead, or the prophets are dead? Who maketh thou thyself? Who do you make yourself? So now verse 58, he gives the answer. Verse 58. Mashiach said unto them, verily, verily, truly, truly, I say unto you, before Abraham was, before there was an Abraham, before Abraham was born, I am. There it is. They asked him, who do you make yourself? Who are you? He said, before Abraham was born, I am. That's Mashiach Yavashai, as an angel of the Most High. Then took they up stones to cast at him. But Mashiach Abishai hid himself and went out of the temple, going through the midst of them, and so passed by. So now, understanding that the I am is Mashiach Yavashai, as an angel of the Most High, who was there in the beginning, who created all things, created all the worlds by the power of the Most High. Now verse 15. And the Most High said, moreover unto Moses. Remember, the angel is speaking to Moses. Thus shall I say unto the children of Israel, the Most High power of your fathers, the power of Abraham, the power of Isaac, and the power of Jacob have sent me unto you. Now he's giving the answer to his name. This is my name forever. Can't go wrong with this, people. The power of Abraham, the power of Isaac, the power of Jacob. Say, this is my name forever. This is my memorial unto all generations. So when he left, let's see if he, when he left, did he say, did he go tell the elders, the I am have sent me unto you? Let's see what it says. Go and gather the elders of Israel together and say unto them, the Most High power of your fathers, or Yahweh, the power of your fathers, the power of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob appeared unto me. Remember he said that's his name forever, the memorial to all generations. Appeared unto me, saying, I have surely visited you and seen that which was done to you in Egypt. Okay? There it is. The Most High power of Abraham, power of Isaac, and power of Jacob. Now let's go back to Mark. Mark 12 and verse 26. Or verse 25. For when they shall rise from the dead, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels which are in heaven. Let you know that the angels are not having sex, because the angels do not have sperm, first and foremost. Now, verse 26, and as touching the dead, that they rise, have you not read in the book of Moses, how in the bush Most I spake unto him, saying, I am the power of Abraham, and the power of Isaac, and the power of Jacob. He is not, that's his name. Power of Abraham, the power of Isaac, the power of Jacob. He said, that's his name forever and more to all generations. He is not the power of the dead, but the power of the living. ye therefore do greatly err. And one of the scribes came, and having heard them reason together, and perceiving that he had answered them well, asked him, which is the first commandment of all? So a lot of people don't know this. You can ask people this. He's going to give you the answer. Most people don't even know this. Say, which is the first commandment of all? Which is the first commandment of all? And Amashagabsha answered him, the first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Most High, our power is one power. And where he's going? Going back to the law. That's what the commandments are. He's going back to Deuteronomy 6 and 4. Hear, O Israel. See, hear, O Israel, the Most High, our power is one power. That's what he's quoting. You see? That's the first of all the commandments. So how do you get anybody else in that? It said, Shema Yashirala, Alahayanawa, Yahawa Ha. That's what it say, man. I mean, it's, hear, O Israel, the Most High, our power is one. That's the first of all the commandments. Listen, what was Acts, verse 28. Of Mark the 12th chapter. And one of the scribes came, and having heard them reasoning together, and perceiving that he had answered them well, asked him, which is the first commandment of all? What's the first commandment of all? And my servant answered him, the first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Most High, our power, that's a personal possessive pronoun, our power, to who? Israel is one power. Personal possessive pronoun showing ownership. That ownership goes to the 12 tribes of Israel. And thou shalt love the Most High, thy power, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. It's not the first of all the commandments, but it's the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. So all the commandments based upon how we serve the Most High. It's how we serve the Most High and how we serve each other. And the second is like, namely this. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. So that's how the commandments, the 613 laws, moral laws, civil laws, dietary laws, ceremonial laws, and sacrificial laws. And civil laws. The sacrificial law was done away with. It's five sets. We only have four sets now. It's how to serve the Most High. How to what? How to love the Most High, thy power, with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. And how thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. That's what it's all about. How we serve the Most High, how we love the Most High, and how we love each other. Verse 32. And the scribe said unto him, well, master, thou hast said the truth. For there is one power, and there is none other but he. And to love him with all the heart, and with all the understanding, and with all the soul, and with all the strength, and to love his neighbor as himself, is more than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices. And when Amashagabshai saw that he answered discreetly, he said unto him, thou art not far from the kingdom of the Most High. And no man after that does ask him any question. Last of the questions. He said that. And Amashak Abishai answered and said, while he taught in the temple, how say the scribes that Amashak Abishai is the son of David? For David himself said, by the Holy Spirit, see, by the holy angel, by the Holy Spirit, the Most High said to my Lord, sit thou on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. David therefore himself calleth him Lord. And whence is he his son? And the common people heard him gladly. See, what's he quoting from? Psalms 110 and 1. But listen what it says. He's telling you how he's saying this. It's to the Holy Spirit. That he had the gift of the Holy Spirit. That's why the Spirit had me going through the Holy Spirit. And it's just continuing. Psalms 110 and 1. The Most, it said, the Lord said unto my Lord, this is King David, a Psalm of David. The Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. See? So who's David's Lord? A Mashiach, Yahweh Shah. See? That's why he's asking the question. How can be his son when he's calling him his Lord? This Bible. Because he knew about a Mashiach, Yahweh Shah. Tells you in 2 Peter 1 and 20. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. For the prophecy, just like David is prophesying, came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of the Most High spake as they were moved by the Holy Spirit. See, that's why Mashiach Yahweh can say that David had the Holy Spirit to be able to speak the words that he spoke. Period. You know? And here we are, ready for the fulfillment of that. It's happening. It's going to happen. 1 Corinthians 15:24. Then cometh the end, when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power. That's everyone that's in power now going to be brought down. Going to bring down all rule and all authority and power. For he must reign till he have put all enemies under his feet. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. See, that's just what we just read. For he hath put all things under his feet. Remember, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit thee on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. So it says, for he hath put all things under his feet. But when he said all things are put under him, that's all these nations, all powers and authorities brought down. It is manifest that he is accepted, which did put all things under him. The Most High going to be accepted. Who put all things under a Mashiach Yahweh Shah. And when all things shall be subdued unto him, then shall the Son also himself be subject to him, that put all things under him, that the Most High may be all in all. And that's what it's all about. The Most High being all in all. Nobody want to respect him as he is. Therefore, he's going to get the glory. Forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Point blank, no doubt about it. No matter how you think in your wildest dreams or imagination, the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob gonna be all in all. Forever and ever and ever. Everybody gonna know of the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Forever and ever 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 and ever. Forever and ever and ever. Until eternity. Forever. Hello, Yah. Shalom.